like forever since I've been in the studio. I miss it. I miss you, boo.
Absolutely. I miss you, too. I miss being here, Listen Vision Live, and all that good stuff. But welcome to everybody tuning in. It's the Busy With B Show.
Yep.
With Boots, man. I mean, we here. We back. We missed y'all. We took a good week or so off. But we back today. We back in the pocket, getting ready for the holiday season and the turn of the new year and all that good stuff and the arrival of Miss Bella in a little bit.
Yes. So, last week I feel ill. I did not feel well. And it's happening more often. Ladies, help me
about
out.
That time, give me, about
relate.
That time.
It's I'm
about that time.
I'm a little over 7 months. So, I almost never know what I'm going to get. So, it will be some times that I won't be here, but I trust my good fella right here to
hold
down.
We're going to hold it down.
Yes, he's going to hold down the show. I may call in. You know I can't stay
away from my baby. Y'all know she's going to call.
I can't stay away from my baby, and I'll be in the background.
She's going to be remote hosting.
Yeah, remote hosting. I'll sit on the phone the whole time unless somebody call in and want to talk and help Boots out. But
right.
I trust him. He will be holding down the show, and sometimes in the blink of an eye, because you just never know.
Absolutely.
And I'm learning that the rough way. You know, I'm a little older this go around, so Boots will be here in my absence, holding down the Busy mm-hmm. Will be franchise.
Yep. I'm in here. I'm gonna represent. I ain't new to this.
Yeah, you true to this.
That's it.
I really appreciate you taking me under your wing and just really teaching me and grooming me. And
it's been my pleasure.
Yeah,
it's been my
definitely.
Pleasure.
I wouldn't, you know, of course you'd never forget those people that just take
absolutely
and train
absolutely.
You up. You know, we grow together, we go together, all that good stuff.
All that.
Today's show, I have Donetta Wilson. Mm-hmm. She's going to join us in the studio. And it kind of made me want to touch on gun violence and how it has affected me. You know, just share one story of, trust me, I have more than one.
Well, let the people know who Miss Wilson is.
Miss Wilson is Makaya Wilson's mom. Mm-hmm. She's coming up on, about 5 months since she was killed over there in Clayton's.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, I remember that story. The young dudes popped out and just started all that gunfire and the little cut, you know, the little apartment circle or whatever you want to call it. Young lady got hit and she passed away.
10 years old. And I think a lot of times we focus on she had two kids that actually, you know, fall victims. You know, not fall victim, but one we know we lost Makaya. She was 10 years old, mm-hmm. and then her older daughter also was wounded trying to protect her daughter. So it's the good thing is that she'll be in the studio. We'll get to hear from her herself, and she'll be able to tell that story. And we'll be able to go from there, ask questions, all that good stuff. And you always can call in at 315-954-0688.
You know that number by heart already?
I know the number by heart.
I don't know. You better than me.
Yeah, but I definitely wanted to just touch a little bit on gun violence. I wanted Boots and I to both share a story of just how gun violence a lot of times, of course, everyone knows I'm straight from Southeast Washington, D.C., born and raised. That's where my family's from. And, of course, as you grow, you branch out and you live different places because now at this point we can't afford to stay where we grew up at.
Right.
And we talking about it, but I don't really see, you know, how it's just not reasonable.
Yeah.
So, of course, when you going through life, where you from don't determine the person you become. You know, it can determine who you become, mm-hmm. but it doesn't define who you are, especially if you don't let it.
That's a jewel, yeah.
Yeah. So with that being said, I wanted to talk about just gun violence and how it directly affected me. Just share a story, which of course no one really fell victim. But it was just material. But 2016, I came home early from work, and at this time I was working in Bethesda. So if you guys are not familiar with Bethesda, Bethesda is rich. You know, that's where the money is. Area code 20814, look it up. But I was working in Bethesda. I was traveling from Southeast because, again, I was living at home with my mom. And I came home early from work. At that time, I was a manager for the company I worked for. So I came home early. Normally, I go to happy hour and, you know, come on in the house. But this particular day, I came home and stayed home. I was tired. Around maybe 8 o'clock, again, it's 2016. You just hear pop, 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 pop. You just hear the whole neighborhood like it's fireworks going off. And, you know, again, I'm from Southeast. I get down on the floor. I'm looking for my daughter, making sure, you know, we down. And come to find out, neighbors and everybody knocked on the door. A little young guy, he was hit. He later told me that my car saved his life. But my car was shot up.
Like how many times you would say?
About. I at least had at least 10 gun
bullet holes.
Bullet holes. My windows were shot out. My car was shot. It was shot up, mm-hmm. basically.
Yeah.
And so just to have to call out of work, you know, I was like, dang, because a part of me was ashamed a little bit.
Of course.
Again, where you work.
You in Bethesda.
Yeah, you where you work and how you present yourself. Nobody ever think I'm from where I'm from. You know, they tell me, where you from? They always give me North Carolina, Georgia, you know, but it's just, I didn't become a product of my environment. I feel like I was a lucky one, but at the end of the day, I never really looked at myself like Southeast, you know. So I never really carried myself like that, but I just always knew God and was introduced to Him early in life and wanted more for myself. But that just goes to show, yeah, I had to call out of work, and I did share the story to, you know, you share with one person, it's like telling the whole office. And I told you, you know, I used sick leave, but I called, you know, I did tell a friend that, you know, my car was shot up. I really can't make it to work.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just the thing. And so now they just look at me like, oh, the girl from Southeast who car was shot up, you know, but she think, you know, where you from don't define you unless you let it.
Right.
So, I mean, just, it was just crazy. But that was just one of the ways that a lot of times where we from, we kind of take and hold that and be ashamed of it, you know, but I'm proud to say where I came from and how I made it out, but we can't let that directly affect who we are as individuals.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, unfortunately, I don't have very many stories of how gun violence has affected me. Hold on real quick. Man, can we get a little... How it has really affected me, and my direct loved ones or what have you. I do have some family members that have gotten involved in some things that have affected them. But I'll use the story of so I'm from, in contrast to Miss B here, I'm from a suburb. I'm from PG County. I'm from Fort Washington, as a matter of fact. And you know, when we first moved to Fort Washington, it was a very affluent community.
Right.
For a long time, it was the highest, you know, it was the where the black people made the most money in America, those type of communities.
Right.
So around about the 90s, around the turn of the 90s, that's when everything started changing. You know what I mean? That's when everything started changing to the point of you started seeing robberies. Mm. You started seeing people getting jumped and people, you know, hanging on the corner under the street lights, so on and so forth. And so I would say my story is how it affected just my community where I grew up. People started getting shot. People started getting killed. Things started happening. And because of that, as you can imagine, that brought the police presence.
Mm-hmm.
And once the police presence came in, that's when the police we started seeing police strong arm people, right, using kind of some real aggressive tactics to police our community. And so it really had a real, real snowball effect on our community just from the actions of a few. So,
but I think what was happening too is back. I mean, even it's still happening now. We moving on them borderlines of Fort Washington,
yeah,
and
absolutely,
know, we can't really afford to stay right there where we grew up at.
Yeah,
so that violence is traveling.
Absolutely.
You know? So that's mm-hmm. what's happening. But it's up to us to take care of us as a people, as a individuals, as African Americans. We can no longer point the finger at politicians, and you know, no, at this point we killing each other, we doing it to each other, and easily, you know, easily, because of where I had to grow up at, you know, I could have been a victim of you know, just being shot. It's been times where I'm coming home and I'm coming in and you see a group of guys. This story right here is actually my sister's story. She was coming in one night to come to my mom's house, and a group of guys was coming out the gate with guns. She was confused, didn't know which way to go, you know. But it's just luckily they wasn't on the one where they wanted to take somebody out. But it's just like, we as young people, as kids, we don't have a choice, you know. So if you out there gang banging and still shooting up neighborhoods, I mean, you have a choice. I mean, you want to have a kid one day, or, you know, if this was happening to your family, if that was your daughter, you know, it's easy for me to say, what if that was my child that mm-hmm. got taken away? You know, you never should have to imagine your child being taken away in such a violent way,
right,
just because we have no choices, really, at this point of how we grew up and where we live, and especially as kids. We don't, that's what our mom determined right now, you know. So just the fact that she was cut short and victimized by something that I'm sure could have been avoided. No, nobody fight no more. What's up with that?
They suckers.
What's up with that?
Yeah, man, people, I could go on and on about that, but at the end of the day, people are just scared. They're scared. They're scared of getting beat up, scared of what could come from just losing a fight. And like I said, I could go on and on about that, but it's just the world we live in right now, unfortunately.
It's happening so close to the schools. It's just no respect.
Yeah.
I mean, it's no respect how, at least back in the day, it used to be for the kids. You move out the way. You're not rolling the blunt when people trying to enter the hallway. I mean,
and see, and the other thing is back in the, you know, Sam, just like you, I'm sure, I remember the late 80s, you know, the crack era of D.C., when D.C. was the murder capital, and, you know, murder and violent crime was ridiculous in this area. But at least back then, a lot of it was over money. You know, it might have been illegal drug trade or what have you, but there was, you know, it was a real issue. You know, you stole some money from me, you shorted me some money, something like that. Right. Now, you looked at me wrong. I don't like what you did on Instagram. You know, you tried to go on me on Facebook. You know, you said something about my girl, and it just escalated from there. Yeah. It's crazy. It's ridiculous, so... It just kind of lets you know the mindset of our society in general, and the devaluing of life in general.
It's such a devalue to our own lives. And it's just like, if we don't value our life, how can we expect the hospitals to value our lives?
Yeah.
I mean, the very much thing that we complain about.
Yeah, you know? It's systematic, though. And that's a whole other show, too. It's very much, a lot of the stuff that we're talking about is very much systematic and has been going on since the moment we stepped foot in this country. But I don't want to get on my soapbox tonight, so I'm going to chill.
Look, we got some time. We waiting for Donetta to join us in the studio. She phoned me and said she was running behind. But
you want to take a quick break and regroup and all that good stuff?
Yeah, we can.
Hey, let's do that.
Yeah. In the meantime, while we take this break, we're going to share some pictures of Micaiah and just some pictures of her and her mom interacting and stuff like that. And I didn't say this before, but it'll be nice if we can put it with some something, some nice little tunes.
On the spot.
On the spot. But yeah. So we waiting for her to come in the studio, guys, and we'll be back.
Don't you go nowhere. We'll be right back, y'all. Busy with B. What up?
Welcome back. She's here. She made it through traffic. And everything, and like I said before, she wasn't here. I don't know if she was watching on her way to the studio, but we are going to remember Micaiah. We're going to celebrate the life of Micaiah, and we're going to talk about the future and just some of the things that Donetta is doing in the neighborhood. I see a lot of things going on, and I told her once, you know, I give birth to baby Bella. I'm joining in the fight of, you know, just walking against gun violence and all that good stuff.
Absolutely.
But introduce yourself to the show. I mean, unless you're under a rock, you know what happened to Micaiah almost 5 months ago, right?
Yeah.
So just introduce yourself.
I'm Donetta, Micaiah's mom. I'm glad to be here. I appreciate you, like I said, for you putting this together, because a lot of people have stories that they, you know, that they believe what happened on that day.
And so I just want,
Absolutely.
I just, you know, I'm just great, you know, appreciative to have, be able to tell my own part of the story.
Tell your story. Yeah. It's all yours. The floor is yours. So on the day of Micaiah's death, tell us, how was it even looking at home? Just how was that day?
It was an amazing day. I woke up fussing at her brother. So she was always Micaiah, mom, you know, calm down. You know, normal kid things with your kids, chores that's not being done. My son, he's the only boy.
Yeah.
So he's spoiled.
That's how I was.
So I'm like, you gotta get this done. I'm going crazy. So Micaiah's like, mom, you know, calm down. That day was so amazing to me because, you know, Micaiah, she loved all her siblings, but she loved her older sister and her brother.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that date is just like, she was taking up for her big brother. Then her and her sister was able to go out, you know, in due time. But my oldest daughter, she work a lot, you know. So they don't really get to have a lot of sister bond time. She always jumping in her pictures, jumping in her snaps, you know. Being a normal little sister.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
they don't really get to, you know, spend that time. So just, you know, you never know when stuff like this gonna happen. So now looking back on it and seeing, like, that was so amazing to me that she got her special time. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then, like, we never knowing that that was gonna happen.
Right.
But that was amazing to me because I'm like, dad, I tell her all the time, I say, you gotta make time for your sisters and brothers. You know, you gotta do different things. You gotta do this. And just on that day, for something tragic to happen. But, you know, we got good memories out of it.
Good.
And I hope you guys hold on to those good memories of her forever.
Right.
Absolutely. So what are some of the things that you want to dispel, any rumors, any falsehoods that people have been talking about? Like B said, you know, we want to give you an opportunity to say the truth and what your story. So can you touch on some of the things that you've heard or that people are saying that you know that aren't true? And really give the truth about what happened or how it happened or what have you?
No problem. That day, they say a lot that Micaiah was coming. She was walking from the ice cream truck. She was going to the ice cream truck. She had already been to the ice cream truck. So she was actually sitting on the front with her older sister. So a lot, you know, sometimes they do get the story. And then I'll tell different ones that I talk to on a regular basis. Like a lot of the channels don't really stay, like, right on me. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They'll hear something else, and they'll probably try to put their things together. But, like,
that's
4,
news,
you know,
though.
7, a lot, you know, with the posts, a lot of them, they try to keep, they talk to me. So when they talk to me, they'll know actually what happened.
Right.
But, yeah, she wasn't going to the ice cream truck, or she wasn't coming. She had went to the ice cream truck that day, but that particular time, she was actually sitting on her front.
And a lot of people think it was just Micaiah. You know, we don't talk a lot about your other daughter, who was also struck by a bullet, you know, so it just really took over your family that day. And just, I can only imagine her. She survived and, you know, she lost her little sister. I mean, what has life been like at home, you know, just for your older daughter, you know?
Yeah, it's been difficult for us all, you know. I see stuff like this and hear about it a lot, you know, different areas and stuff like this, but you never knowing that it will be this close to home.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd be my child. So we taking stuff daily. We taking stuff day by day. My pastor, he's supportive a lot. You know, all the walks and everything we doing, we do that a lot. We trying to start doing more family things. You know, I'm trying to get them to open up more to me because it's more that I know my kids be hurting, but they know that I'm hurting so much. So we all try to be the big people for each other.
You try to hold each other up.
Yeah, yeah, definitely try to hold each other up. You know, we all have our breakdowns. So to certain people, like, at the balloon release, everybody was looking at my oldest daughter like, oh my gosh, she having a breakdown. And they looking at me like, mom, she having a breakdown. I'm like, baby, y'all don't know how many breakdowns we have. Yeah. We got our happy mamas, then we got our down mamas. I'm in the house. She walked right past me. My friend like, she see you crying. I'm like, you know how many times she done saw that?
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's not that like, we're like, okay, well, but we see it so much and we there for each other so much that we just like, okay, she's having one of her moments. So we just, that's the bigger things. Like things that we wasn't doing before, like, you know, talking more and trying to just, you know,
spend time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And be with each other.
And grasp each other's feelings. Because a lot of times, like I said with my son, you would think he would drive you crazy. Especially as being a little brother, you know. Yeah. But I'm explaining to them that, see, you just need a little bit of attention. You know, so when he get that, they be like, oh. But then the kids, they like, wow, he's getting on my nerves. you know what I'm saying? But I'm like, him and my youngest daughter, Makaya.
Right.
They did so much together.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So now that's taken away from him, he don't want to be a crybaby.
So give us the age. I mean, because we know Makai was 10.
Yeah.
And I don't know exactly how many kids you have. So.
Five.
Okay, yeah. Yeah. I wanted to know.
Yeah, what's that age?
See, even my 8-year-old, she's into the story. So when I told her that you were coming on the show, she was like, I mean, mommy. So she started talking about it, and it's so crazy because what is put out there in the media, you know, my 8-year-old is saying, you know, and I'm just
a lot
like,
of kids, her classmates, and everything. Yeah. They call me, you know, and I'm doing something with the school where I told them, I don't care, night or day. Like, if they feel like they want to talk to me, because sometimes it just be that they like, you know, we just want to make sure you're okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I do a lot of stuff with the school as well. We've got something coming up. That's what I was telling you for the 16th.
And this is the great part of having you on the show. And you are now a friend to the show.
Absolutely.
So, and with that being said, you are able to come on and talk about the things that's happening in the community. And like I told you, after we birth Bella, you know, we are going to be in the community.
Absolutely.
One of the things
absolutely.
I'm working on behind the scene is an organization. But like I said, I'm really looking for a church home.
Okay.
And so it's like I really want to, you know, find some backing. But I'm looking to start that organization and that mentorship because I know in our community going through the transition of life, you know, when we need that extra push,
right?
You know, to transition from middle school to high school to kind of figure out which way we want to go in life, we don't have it,
right?
So
right.
It's people like you who have experienced such a loss that I will never sit here and say, oh, I can just imagine,
right?
You know, I'm sad for you, and no mom should ever have to put their baby to rest. Yes. That 10 years.
Not like that for sure. You know, definitely not like that.
Especially not like that.
Absolutely.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, and I know that it makes you value life more.
Yes, definitely.
And just take it all in with your other 4 kids.
Yes.
And Makaya is still around. I'm sure she is.
Definitely.
I know she's moving and shaking in the house.
Man, what? When I say that little girl, I was telling me the other day, I'm like, yeah, I'm telling you, you got to meet her. The little girl was so lit. Sometimes that I be so drained and I be like, wow, you know, I think about all the funny times. Even that day, like I said, she was peeking her head back and forth in the house, doing her little dances and stuff. So I'd be like, different songs to come on. I'd be like, wow, that's my crazy baby. Like that little girl, she was off the chain. So it's like the sad moments when you think about them moments, because a lot of people, I post so many things and I have so many pictures and so many memories that people be like, wow. Like, me as a parent, it do something to me because I don't got but 5 pictures of my baby. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, wow, well, that's all I did. My kids drove them nuts. Take a picture everywhere we go.
Right.
It's a picture, you know? So I am grateful that I was able to get them, you know,
those
a
moments.
Lot of moments, you know what I'm saying, that I can remember with that. Because like I said, you know, never, you can't prepare for nothing like this.
Absolutely.
And it shouldn't be like this, you know, but where we're from, we can't really plan like, you know, someone that's from the suburbs or someone that's from the other part of town. When you're from these neighborhoods, I mean, I know even me as a woman growing up in Southeast, I was just like, you know, oh, okay, if I make it to 18, and, you know, I've never been in trouble. You know, I'm fortunate enough to never have traveled down certain roads. But it's just like mentally, you know, we don't, we can't train ourselves like somebody else who already, you know, come from a structured background in a neighborhood where they don't have to worry about losing their life, just going to their car. Or, you know, so it's just where we're from. But it's up to us to take our streets back. You know, we can't look for the politicians. You know, we know the drugs are out there. We know the guns are out there. But what are we going to do? You know, we can't keep losing. I mean, because everybody lose on both ends. The the people that took Micaiah. And, you know.
And their families.
And their families. Everybody lose. And it's just like for us not to see that. For us not to think that. We fighting a losing battle against ourselves. And one of, this was my inspiration for starting this show, was just seeing so many people that I went to school with. I posted my first video, and I just started praying. And I was like, I've been wanting the podcast, been on my mind. And I posted my video, Weedy and his wife got killed. And I think Makai wasn't far after that. But when they got killed, I posted my video, and I just spoke from my heart. And it got over 1,000 views, and I said, you know what, that's my, that's what I'm supposed to do. And, and so to have you on the show, and I'm sorry it's these circumstances, you know, it's just, I'm so happy you're here. I want you to now, we're going to celebrate Micaiah. And I want you to now tell the world and tell the community what you're doing now to kind of remember the life and remember the legacy and what you'll be doing in the future.
Definitely. It's so, like, I promise you, I wake up, it'd be different things. And people be like, wow, well, why you didn't tell me about this? I wake up and I'd be like, what? I want to have a party. I'm walking. They be like, well, I ain't know. You know what I'm saying? So that's how I be now. The biggest thing I definitely want to do, the all the walks. We definitely want to do that. My pastor showed me something new with the lighting up the sky thing. I love that. You know, I always heard about it, but
is
I never actually did it.
Is that when you have the lanterns?
So we did it one time for her walk that we just had. We doing another one on the 16th. That'll be her 5 months. Of her tragic death. So we'll be doing that. And then like a little Christmas lighting thing too. So, and then the following day, I'll be doing something at her school. But definitely, I'll keep you posted. That's the next thing that I have so far coming up. But we're going to be doing a whole lot of different things. So, I'll keep you posted.
And it's just all about just, you know, I think one of the things you stressed to me, too, is you wanted it to be known that, you know, this really wasn't full attention for yourself. I think, and I wanted you to release that burden from you, you know, because I think it's very important that it's okay that a mommy want to keep her baby alive, you know, through activities and, you know, through giving back. It's done all the time, you know, and it's just your way of keeping her spirit with you. So I wanted to tell you in front of everybody, don't you ever feel ashamed for wanting to get out there and do things. It directly affected you. So now you have a whole different passion than anybody else has. So you keep doing your thing.
And that's what I try my best to. You know, we it's a crazy world we live in. So, you know, I am human and I have feelings. So a lot of times, you know, I try my best, and my pastor tell you, I be trying, because sometimes I be in the house, and I be like, wow, okay, that's not a nice word. We can't say it like that. These people are crazy, you know what I'm saying? And, like, for you to be, for even you, even if you don't know the story of her being 10 years old, you got to know that this is never, never okay, you know?
Never
They words, and sometimes things they do, it hurt my feelings. So that's when I act out, but I try my best to always think about, okay, Micaiah's mom.
What? And now you have an audience and people are watching you. So it's just like, now what are you going to do with that? You know, so you can take and hold on to positive. Or, you know, you can let the negative bring you down. Because people will always say what they want to say, but it's up to you to choose. You know, so like I choose to be happy. You know, I always chose to be positive no matter what. You know, we didn't have a lot to be thankful for, you know. But it's a choice. And I teach my daughter that. Choose to be happy. You ain't control of what. So it's just kind of like feeding ourselves the positive things. And if anybody not giving them positive vibes, shake them off.
Right. And that's what I've been doing. Trust me, slowly but surely, it'll be like, well, I haven't heard from you. That was no purpose. However, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I got to definitely stay, you know, positive and keep myself, because with everything that have happened, like I tell people, my life, I will never be the same. Yeah. So if I don't keep myself in positive things, around positive things, then that make me in a whole nother spirit, and I don't want to be there.
The great thing is that you do have a church on me. You do have a pastor. So that's a start. And just having that positive, when you put out positive, you get positive back.
Definitely.
And just like this, I'm sitting in the studio. I was wondering, like, we cut the show. Sure, I'm like, Boost, you're going to break. And he like, News 4 is here, and they want to. I'm like, huh? I mean, and it was a shock, but I'm just little things like that. Yeah, someone like, coming to capture,
right. You know, your story.
Yeah. You know, mm-hmm. And you wonder, 5 months later, are people really here for you? Are people still supporting you? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, things of that nature. So just to see News 4 take that time out to come here and capture a glimpse of your story to put it out there to the world, I commend you guys.
Yes. So recently, I saw that another person was arrested over the situation. Mm-hmm. That makes like seven people at this point, right? Which I thought was very ironic, being that you was coming on the show today, and that just happened. So I wanted to ask, when that happens, when these people are being apprehended, does that give you any type of satisfaction, or does that feel like any like type of small victory for yourself?
It do, and then it's very overwhelming because, again, you hear about these things, and as you get the phone calls and the thing, mind you, when y'all hear, mind you, I done heard it 3,000 times.
Yeah,
you
know?
It's like overwhelming, but it's a good overwhelming, but it'd be like, wow, you know, this is actually my child.
Right.
So it's like a, you know, it's definitely relieving that they're getting them, trust me. But it's just, you know, for all of this being so new and me, you know, just trying to grasp everything, it sometimes it get overwhelming.
Right, yeah, it's only been 5 months. Yeah. I mean, it seems to us that aren't directly involved. It seems like it's been a while, but it's only, it hasn't even been half a year yet.
Yes.
And so I can imagine.
Me, it's like it's yesterday.
Every
absolutely. Day, I'm like, wow. Absolutely.
You know,
and Christmas coming.
Yeah.
I can only imagine. Mm-hmm. Like, my baby went for Christmas. So just knowing just some of the things that you are fighting with and going through, I commend your family, and your beautiful daughter is here with you in the studio. And I mean, so it's just, you can, I know, because we talk, how you don't want to stay right there. You expressed to me that sometimes when people see you in the street and you could be having a good day and they just saying, oh, Micaiah's mom. Yeah. It's just like, you don't always want to be reminded. Yeah. And it's okay. You know, you want to have a good day.
Right.
So I wanted to, it's like I talked to you beforehand. And a lot of times before the guests come on, I try to like talk to them and get personable just a little bit so I can know and pull out things that you may forget.
Mm-hmm.
But I wanted to bring that up for you.
Right. Because that definitely, that's one of the big things because, I like I said, every day, me and my kids and my son, he joke about it all the time. He's like, oh my goodness, mom, they act like we famous. And I'm like, well, Lord Mike, it's kind of that we are at this point because everybody know us. You know, we go in the streets, we in restaurants. They like, oh my goodness, that's the family. That's the sister. That's the so it's like, if I'm in the good spirit and I'm like, okay, well, I'm having a good day. You come up to me. I understand where it's coming from, but sometimes that bring me down, you know, because I could be in a good spirit. But as soon as that one hug or then that one, I can understand. Because mind you, it's so many people. Like this lady told me in the Uber the other day. She was like, I just want to get out and park. Can I hug you? And I felt bad because I didn't want the hug. Mm-hmm. But I'm like, okay, well, let me take this hug. Because if you saw it in her face that she was just like, I said, when I see you ever in life, I just wanted to hug you. That's all I wanted to do. You know, so it's like I have to be that person that be like, okay, you know what? This lady probably need this hug.
Has people across the country and the nation, I mean, because this story went national, have people across the country reached out to you guys? And
definitely. Different jails, you know, they was reaching out to me.
Mm-hmm.
Overseas, it was different. It's crazy. Like, something my DMs, it go crazy because it's like a lot of them guys, they haven't saw their kids for like 10 and 12 years. Yeah. They like, for them killing babies and stuff, they reached out to me.
It's so sad. And it's just like, I want our community, and I say this because this is where I'm from, you know, and I grew up in these streets. I just was fortunate enough not to be struck by a gun, and I know I shared my story But I have many a stories of just gun violence.
Gun violence, yeah.
And just because, you know, we made it out, but it's up to us to police our streets.
Definitely.
You know, and take these guns away. And it's just like, what's beef? You know, yeah. What is yeah. that? Mm-hmm. You know, it's just... I'm just not getting it to the point where we got to worry about losing our kids. Our yeah. 8-year-olds. Mm-hmm. I mean, the innocent ones.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. so.
Not revealing a lot. Have they ever given any information about how this all started?
Yeah. It basically was gang related through mm-hmm. the two neighborhoods. You
okay.
know, so it was like a lot going on. It was basically supposed to be a shooting there, and then it was mm-hmm. a shooting here. It was basically like they looking at it now was basically investigating it under gang related throughout the neighborhood.
And is the investigation ongoing at this point?
Yeah, most
okay.
definitely.
Okay.
That's why it's definitely different, you know, new people. And,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's definitely ongoing.
Wow, man.
Like I said, I definitely keep y'all posted. I'm a friend, you know, yeah. friend of the show.
And anything
man.
You need, so, any support, yeah. any yeah. if you need us to come out for anything, these walks and okay. and tributes to her, please let us know. I know I can speak for the both of us, and we'll definitely be there.
Okay.
To support you guys any okay. way we can, for sure.
No problem. Yeah. That's what B was telling me. You know, when she first reached out, and like I appreciate y'all too, because that was my biggest thing. Everybody make up their stories and do and yeah. say on what they want. But I'm the mom. You know mm-hmm, what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I just, you know, I want everybody to know, you know what I'm saying, how my child was. And all the time, like the ones that even hurt now of the story, like, trust me, if you would have been able to know her, it would have been even tragic, you know, because that yeah. little girl, like I said, for her only to be 10, Micaiah was so special because she wanted everything to always work.
Yeah.
Even in my neighborhood, like, she brought all the kids to my house. I'm like, Micaiah, who is that?
When is Micaiah's birthday?
May 31st.
Okay.
Yeah, you about to be on your astrology stuff.
Yeah, so it's like, the girl, she was like a peacemaker at 10.
Yeah.
So it's like, even in my neighborhood, she knew people around there I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, wow, I'm down the streets, grown people like, hey, Micaiah. I'm like, who are you? That's the new grown woman, but it's like, that's how it was. So, you know, that definitely keep my spurs lifted, and, you know, just keep me
absolutely.
Stay focused.
Absolutely,
and I
absolutely.
Definitely want you to stay focused. Yeah. You have the platform now, and, you know, it came in a crazy way, mm-hmm. you know, and God obviously felt that Micaiah was ready,
yeah.
you know, so now you have a platform, you have an audience, mm-hmm. and it's up to you to promote positive and mm-hmm. put your word out there and things that you want
mm-hmm.
to be out there.
Mm-hmm.
And just remember, people going to say something, whether definitely. You're doing bad or good.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So you remember just to do good and do what you can and yeah. stay prayed up and stay around people that motivate you and uplift you. And
most
I promise
definitely.
You, we can revisit this in 6 months to a year, whatever.
Okay.
Life would just be... just greater.
Okay.
Because you changing your mind. You choosing to be happy.
Right, right.
And choose to put yourself around people that want to see good for you. You have the audience.
Thank you.
So do your
absolutely.
Thing.
Thank you.
So tell us, we winding down.
Mm-hmm.
You was a little late, you
yes.
know. We could have talked all day.
Right.
But we winding down. So I want you to tell the audience on the 16th. You got okay. something coming up on the 16th?
Yes. Okay. On the 16th, we're going to do a tree lighting. We're going to do a tree lighting and the light up the sky thing I was telling you
okay,
about.
Okay, where
so
is it going to be?
That's going to be at Clay Terrace.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're going to do that.
Is police going to be there?
Yeah, the police. Okay. We always had the police
okay.
out. And the news.
That'd
be another big thing. That they be. No, she's not the only one. Because they always ask. They be like, look, it's no shade to you or Micaiah, but is the police going to be there? They was asking for the walks. So trust me, I get it
no,
because,
when
again,
I tell you. No, when you
it
young,
don't stop.
When you young, it's just like you have this certain, I mean, just to know I was walking these same streets of,
right.
you know, Southeast,
right.
I was like so carefree.
Yeah.
Wasn't thinking about like gun violence
right.
and stuff. And as I got older, I always share the story how I was with mom for a
mm-hmm.
while. But as I got older, it was just like, I'm nervous to get out yes. the car. Like,
seriously.
You know, so it's
seriously.
Just like, no, honestly, when you have so much to live for, it's up to you to protect yourself. Just
right.
like I'm saying, it's up to us to protect our community.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So at this point, we know what's out there. So I'll be a fool not to ask, so,
yeah.
you know. With, you know,
what's
protect
going on?
Yourself,
yeah,
protect
definitely.
Your family. And
I mean, and I'm telling you, it'd be Ubers. I went in the Uber, and he was like, oh, I'm not going up that street.
That's
a little girl got killed. And mind you, that's my child.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm sitting up to the man like, that's
not,
my child.
Yeah,
he like, baby girl, I'm not going up that street. And I felt them because I was like, wow. But I get it all the time. A lot of people, because that's why, like, her birthday and different things like that, I'm going to do it in a mutual park. Because I'm not mad at them. I understand. And you know, a lot of people don't want to do that particular area. But that's where it happened at. So that's why, like, a lot of balloon releases and stuff like that, I do it right there.
I think we should be able to do it wherever you know. Yeah. Like you said, where it happened. Like, hey, and that's what we are there for, you know, to support. And I think that'd be crazy. But, yeah, we should show up where we need to show up at.
Thank you. Have you noticed that, real quick, that particular community or their surrounding community, things have kind of calmed down, maybe? Because of that, the people out there have been more aware of what they're doing and kind of more...
You must have been here then. Yeah. Because remember, it was another little girl.
Mm-hmm. Right after that.
Right after that.
Same area?
Same area. Yeah. So, mm-hmm.
It's like, looking wise, they boarded it up. Yeah. They did a lot of things. But have it changed? No.
But they did move you away from that.
Yeah, they
community.
That night I got out of there. If they was gonna move me or not, it was not a game.
That's
why I tell people, like, I definitely would never live there, but because that's what happened at.
Right.
I do different things.
Absolutely.
There, you know, but I'm gonna do a mutual spot as well.
At the end of the day, we are here no matter where you are. We're gonna show up. You know, that was just a little, you know, giggle.
I you.
But it's just like, yeah, I want my daughter to see things like this. Like I said, she is so involved, and she's 8 years old, so I want to know. And you definitely have my support.
Yeah.
Busy with B Show and Boots.
Yeah.
We are in the building. And you guys, we have to wind it down. You guys can find me at Facebook as Zakiya Miss B Johnson, also at Busy with B on Facebook, on Instagram at Miss B One. And each and every Monday right here at 6 on Listen Vision Live with my boy Boots.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, thank everybody for tuning in. Did you want to shout out any social media, anything for yourself, especially so they can follow, come to the events?
Also, a lot of people don't know what you do. Yeah. A lot of people don't know that you are an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
And that you do, because on Busy With B, we have entrepreneurs that come on the show and share their story, especially when they come from the areas, Southeast Washington or anywhere, but just to come on the show to uplift, motivate, and uplift the community. But she is an entrepreneur, and I think and a really good one. So I think that should be touched on.
Yeah, let them know.
Yeah, definitely. My main page is Miss Natural Styles. Everything is spelled the right way. I know a lot of people always ask that. It's Miss Natural Styles. And my hair page is at Slave with Daughters. Everything is spelled the right way as well.
All right. Well, check her out, y'all. Check her out.
And thank you again.
Thank you. Thank you for coming in. We appreciate your family, your daughter,
your family,
and everybody for coming through.
Yes. Thanks. Yes. Tune in next Monday right here on the Busy with B Show.
See ya.
See ya.